In this video, I'm going to show you guys one of the best gunsmith builds and attachments that you can possibly use to make your Type 25 the best Type 25 in the game right now. So I'm not even going to lie, guys, these are the best attachments so far. I've done a lot of research, actually, and I've tested a lot of builds, and this is the one, guys. This is the one. You know, before I drop in and, you know, show you guys everything, the build attachments and, like, how to use this gun in this new season, you know, the season just dropped and this new Type 25 just dropped as well. So, yeah. So before I continue with all that good stuff, I just want to tell you guys only a small percentage of you guys that actually watch my videos are, you know, actually subscribed. If you guys end up watching this video and, you know, if I give you any good info or intel, please consider subscribing. It's totally free and you can always change your mind. So with that being said, let's go ahead and dive right into this video, boys. The Type 25 is one of the most OG weapons in Call of Duty Mobile. Alongside, it came out all the way from beta to season zero, and it's still in the game, but, you know, it's still not dominant as it was before. You know, it was one of the best assault rifles back in the day, and right now it's kind of like, you know, meh. It's kind of like in the middle. So, you know, in today's video, I'm going to show you guys these gunsmith builds and attachments for the Type 25 that's going to actually bring it up of, like, really high up in there in the meta right now in this current season, in this new season that just dropped, guys. Hope you guys, you know, are enjoying the new season as well. But with that being said, guys, if you guys haven't yet, check out the Huntress draw, the lucky draw. It's in the game right now. It just came out recently, and, you know, that actually motivated me to make this video. So, you know, because I thought, you know, a lot of you guys would be using it, and I was like, you know, why not? Why not help the public out, boys? So with that being said, guys, so this is it. I'm going to show you guys the gunsmith build right now here. As you guys can see the screenshot right now, I'm going to leave it up for a little bit. Make sure I screenshot it. And if you know, happen to not get the chance to screenshot it, just, you can just go back. So that being said, guys, in my attachments that I actually put down here, guys, I do have equipped the Monthic Suppressor, the MIP Light Barrel, the Rubberized Grip Tape, the Stopping Power Reload, and the OWC Laser Tactical. And I'm just gonna briefly run down to what I put these attachments on, because, you know, actually the Type 25 in this current meta, you know, there actually haven't been any buffs or nerfs to this gun that I know of. I mean, I don't know if there's any soft nerfs or buffs, but that's behind the scenes. You know, we only find out, only like true Type 25 players can actually, you know, feel that. So that being said, guys, I did check it out. I did play with this gun for quite long, and I haven't really noticed anything except for a buff, a small buff, and I don't know if that's just me or if that's just this gun right now. Yeah, it's just because probably I just haven't played in a while, but this gun felt really extremely strong in this current meta. So with that being said, guys, the Monthic Suppressor, I do have it put on. It's going to increase your range really drastically high, and you really need that because I didn't really equip any other range buffing attachments except for the Monthic Suppressor. With that being said, I did equip the MIP Light Barrel. This is the reason, because it's to increase your ADS speed. You really want to have a high agility and high amount of reflexes to actually, you know, utilize this gun and the way I have utilized it in the gameplay, as you guys are seeing right now. So what the MIP Light Barrel does is going to give you buff up the ADS speed, but it's going to nerf down the accuracy, a little bit of horizontal recoil, a little bit of vertical recoil, but it's not that much. It's like 1%, which is barely anything, not even a difference, but only the accuracy is like by a lot, by a little bit. So that being said, guys, that's going to give you ADS speed and give you high amount of agility here. So that being said, our next attachment is going to be the Stopping Power Reload. It's going to be the core attachment of this Type 25 right now. As you know, what this is going to do, you guys can already see it. It's going to buff up the damage insanely high, going from, you know, around 40 to all the way to 60 damage. So that's going to be huge. And that, you know, this attachment does come with drawbacks. It comes with a vertical recoil drawback, a reload time drawback, and an ADS time drawback. So that's gonna all get evened out with the next attachments I do have here. So that being said, the Type 25 does have, you know, a high amount of vertical recoil that as compared to any type of horizontal recoil. Horizontal recoil is really easy to, you know, control and, you know, fix, but vertical recoil is gonna be pretty hard paired with a horizontal recoil. So our next attachment that I put on is going to be the Rubberized Grip Tape, which is going to heavily focus on vertical recoil control. So it's going to buff, it's going to help you guys lower the vertical recoil insanely badly, and it's going to be really good for you. You don't have to deal with any push up from the left, from the top to the bottom or anything like that. It's going to be fairly smooth, and as you're also going to feel like you have no recoil at all. So Rubberized Grip Tape is going to be our fourth attachment here, boys. So that's going to be that. It's going to help with the vertical recoil. For the last attachment that I do have put on is going to be the OWC Laser Tactical, as we just do need more ADS buff, you know, because Monthic Suppressor decreases the ADS speed, the Stopping Power Reload decreases the ADS speed, And, you know, we needed the OWC Laser Tactical to even it up and also increase it by a far shot. So with that being said, guys, these are all the attachments, and this is what all the attachments are going to do. Now I'm going to show you guys how to actually utilize these attachments and how to implement that into your playstyle, especially using the Type 25 and how to use it, you know, in current meta and ranked games and also in Battle Royale. So that being said, guys, so in ranked games, you really want to be in that mid to short range type of area during your gunfights to actually, like, you know, totally destroy and deny your opponents from anything. Honestly, this gun performs the best in mid range. You know, close range, not as close as you would be with an SMG, but like lower mid, you know what I mean, somewhere around there. You can also go like a little bit above mid range, you know, but not in the long range area, because it's going to be really hard to control your recoil in the long range area. Either you know how to control the recoil in long range, or you know how to one tap your enemies in long range. And one tapping, that's a whole nother theory that I don't want to get into right now. So that being said, guys, either that or that. So you really want to stay in that mid range area, and you really want to be, you know, utilizing all sorts of movement, jumping, proning. Not really, I don't really recommend you guys proning it in this meta at all. Because, you know, the nerf with the prone and with the perks and stuff. So yeah, that's going to be for our next video, how to prone in this current meta. But right now, I do really don't recommend you guys to do that. You really want to utilize sliding and jumping mostly. And, you know, actually, like, getting in their faces. That will be the best thing, because this gun will melt really badly. Will melt them in thin air, and it's going to be really good for you guys. And actually, I did actually end up winning all of my games with this, with this gunsmith build with the Type 25. And also, if you guys haven't yet, make sure you guys check out the Type 25 in the new lucky draw that's right now in COD Mobile. And that actually did motivate me to make this video. So that being said, guys, that's that. You really want to have position yourself in that type of way. You really don't want to, you know, use it like in a long range gun. You don't want to compete with this with in a long range gun, like especially against an ASM-10 or like the HVK or like, you know, all those dominant guns like DRH and whatnot. So that being said, guys, that's that. Hope you guys enjoyed this gameplay and, you know, this gunsmith build. Make sure you guys try it out in your ranked games. Make sure you, let me know how that goes. Let me know in the comment section below how that goes. And if it's good or bad, or if you guys are having a problem, let me know in the comment section below. And also, if you guys want to get on a personal contact level with me, I do have it in the pinned comment down below to join my Discord server. It's a really great community. I do have, that is my personal server, and, you know, anyone that you guys join, you guys are gonna be part of my community. So in that, we do have a lot of people posting gunsmith builds and whatnot, talking in the main chat, asking me questions and whatnot. I'm also replying. I'm really more active there than on, you know, on replying on YouTube, because I'm kind of slacking on that part. So that being said, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Make sure to drop a like, comment, and hit that subscribe button. It's my goal to get to 10K, and you guys are definitely going to help me make that possible, and I know it for sure. You guys definitely are. So that being said, guys, thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure you guys drop by tomorrow. I'm going to have another awesome video for you guys. And yeah, and that's that. And once again, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace. I used to dream it real right now. If it wasn't working, I'm